Hello and welcome to the Sasol GTC Championship. For the first two rounds, we're at the Zwartkops International Raceway on the outskirts of Pretoria. Let's join VW Jetta driver Mathew Hodges for a lap of Zwartkops.
We start our lap and we hook fourth gear as we cross it. Arriving at turn one, we try to carry as much speed as possible, early apex, keeping it there, hard on the throttle as we exit. Arriving at turn two, hard on the brakes, back down through the gearbox, all the way to first gear, watching the oversteer as we exit, back hard on the throttle, up through the gearbox now, up in third, up into fourth through turn three, and we're holding four all the way up, just not enough space to grab fifth gear. Arriving at turn four, hard on the brake pedal, down two clicks on the gearbox, nice early apex, holding it there, getting hard on the throttle as we exit, trying to get the drive out, coming up to the tabletop, arriving at turn five, hard on the brakes again, back down all the way to first gear, turning sharp right, get on the throttle early as possible, getting the drive out, coming up to turn six, carry as much corner speed, this is important to get the drive down, through turn seven here we come, hooking third gear as we exit, and fourth gear, up to the last corner, turn eight, hard on the brakes, nice early apex, and hard on that loud pedal to get that drive out, and as we cross the finish line, that's a lap of Zwartkops.
It started off as a dream. Well-known TV presenter and multiple South African champion Gary Formato had a dream about GTC. Let's find out more.
I'm one of the crazy people that decided to take this on and actually bring a new category of motorsport into South Africa. For a long time, you know, we were busy racing production cars, which was generally where all the manufacturers were involved when it comes to circuit racing. And we didn't notice that we needed something new. You know, the path that we were on wasn't really working, and more importantly, it wasn't sustainable. So we spent a lot of time having a look around the world to see what people were doing with their own domestic touring car championships, which series were working, which weren't working. And obviously there were a couple that were really strong, and you know, Aussie V8, V8 Supercars is an incredibly strong series. British touring cars, his entries were sort of swelling and growing at a fantastic rate. So we started to pick, you know, some of the best components from some of those championships, and we came up with the GTC concept. I think one of the most exciting parts of GTC is the fact that it has attracted South Africa's top circuit racing drivers. There are a couple that are not here that we certainly hope to be joining us in the future, but if you really look at it, I think virtually everybody in the field has won a number of South African titles, won international championships as well, and I think it's really important. It's been a long time since we've had discussions at length about drivers and who's going to be driving cars, and teams have really gone out there to find the best drivers for the cars. And then that's very, very exciting for us, because that's what it should be. It is a top line series, it is the premier series in South Africa, and we definitely have the top drivers in the country here.
We were at Zwartkops for the launch of the Sasol GTC Championship. Formidable interest from the media and the public alike.
This is a momentous day, ladies and gentlemen, a day in which the face of motorsport in South Africa is changing dramatically. The Global Touring Car Championship, GTC Championship. Big round of applause.
And we looked all over the world, basically. We know a lot of people around the world, and we spoke to people and started opening conversation and just understanding what the rest of the world was doing. And eventually started to get to a scenario where, you know, well, that sort of works over there, that's working over there, and you know, try and pull the best of everything and start putting something together.
The element of standardization, it is a cost-effective way to demonstrate our products, to demonstrate the technologies, and we are very excited to be involved in GTC.
It's been a long road, it's been a trying road, a testing road, almost like a roller coaster, lots of ups, lots of downs, but I think that's what makes people in motorsport the caliber of people that they are. My team has been superb. The racing team for the BMW guys, the Sasol BMW racing team, as well as the Volkswagen Jetta, Volkswagen Motorsport team. I mean, they've pulled out all the stops to get the two cars here. They look absolutely resplendent. They're fantastic. Already all the feedback we're getting from everyone is it's what South Africa needs.
Probably one of the proudest moments to actually see that Sasol GTC Championship logo up on the board there today. So I'm happy this day's come, and I'm looking forward to moving on with it and getting the series on the go. For this championship, you're going to see the top drivers in the top cars in the country in circuit racing against each other.
And the most important thing is that we're going to create a platform here in the Sasol GTC Championship that is going to allow people that are partaking to really see a return and start to see the actual value that exists in motorsport, as it does in many other places in the world. And we're happy to be doing that right here now in South Africa.
Qualifying was a tense affair, and some of the drivers got it right. We caught up with them after the event.
We went out there. I'm normally quite calm, you know, before. You can only really go out there and do what you can. Treat it like another practice. I think if you put too much pressure on yourself, that's where you don't really extract the most from the car. So I just went out there, was cool, did my laps that I needed to do, and the car felt great.
Yeah, it's okay. I mean, it was really, really close. The Sasol GTC team did a fantastic job with our BM. We had a little bit of a niggles, you know, in qualifying. A couple of things we're trying to be sorted out from yesterday. So I think we lost a bit of pace there for sure. But the car feels fantastic. The guys have set the handling up, you know, phenomenally. So it's now just about the racing. And I think it's going to be a close race. You know, the qualifying times we were quite close.
With Simon Moss right here at Zwartkops Raceway, qualifying, going into turn one. Simon, car didn't feel right.
Well, we bought the car late last night. We've been in a rush to build the car. The mechanics have done a great job and went straight into qualifying without any practice. Was doing installation laps and going into, or on my lead up lap, on the second lap when I was going under braking, I felt it was a little bit wallowish. And in turn one, coming out of turn one, I was 3/4 of the way on the track, far away from the outside apex. And all of a sudden, about 5 meters out of the corner, my car just dropped on me. And then as I corrected it, I had it under control almost, and then next thing I knew, I was a wheel on the grass halfway down into turn two, and I just slicked the tires and to clip the chassis, so we had a bit of work to do.
It seems like a little bit of suspension damage not long before the first race. Do you think you'll be able to get it done by then?
Luckily, all the push shots and everything are still straight. Hopefully the suspension won't be too bad. It's just, I think we're going to have to bend the chassis straight. It sounds like a big job. Hopefully the mechanics can get it done and be on the grid.
For the first race of the Sasol GTC Championship, it was Audi versus BM versus VW. Let's go and find out how it panned out. Michael Stephen, Mathew Hodges, Gennaro Bonafede, Hennie Groenewald, Graham Nathan, Simon Most. We have the safety car that has made his way out. They're all bunched up coming into the final corner. And here it is, Sasol GTC racing at Zwartkops. Let's go racing! You can see Mathew Hodges just wanting to go, but Michael Stephen has to dictate exactly the pace. And now it is a green flag on the inside. Can Mathew Hodges make it stick? Ooh, I tell you, some very tentative driving over there. But they seem to be going very well into turn two as we try and see exactly what's going on. And it seems as though that Michael Stephen is holding on to the lead as they come around. Yes, Michael Stephen, Mathew Hodges, and we've got the BMW, Gennaro Bonafede in third place. But you can see Graham Nathan all over the back of Hennie Groenewald as they come up towards turn four. Can he go down and dive on the inside? He just holds on, but maybe you'll be able to get him up at the tabletop. And Sean Dermody, of course, leading in the Focus ST in the production car category. But at the moment, it is Michael Stephen who is controlling the pace. Mathew Hodges in second position, Gennaro Bonafede in third, and Graham Nathan all over the back of Hennie Groenewald. Simon Moss has dropped behind the Ford of Sean Dermody. I think there's all sorts of problems for Simon Moss, having just rebuilt that car. It is the end of the first lap of Sasol GTC, and our leader is Michael Stephen from Mathew Hodges. Oh, it's a big dive down the inside for Graham Nathan, trying to get past. Hennie Groenewald decided against that. Maybe he'll try and take him at turn two. He goes into turn two on the inside, and yes, he's made the pass move. A great move there from Graham Nathan, getting past Hennie Groenewald in the Volkswagen Motorsport Jetta. So there we go, takes the inside there. Great move from Graham Nathan. Graham Nathan, Gary, a guy who just knows this track backwards.
Yeah, he certainly does. Very aggressive driver as well. And, you know, really teed it up coming onto the start finish straight there. Really ahead hit his number. I must say, in practice, Graham was struggling with the brake somewhat, but certainly now seems to have got a grip with it. And as we can see by that outbreaking move there. But just looking at the two leaders here, Michael Stephen, Mathew Hodges, you've got to take your hat off to Mathew Hodges. He spent probably the least time out of anybody in one of these cars, and right up there in second place. So really adapting well to the GTC car.
Yeah, terrific to see the caliber of drivers that we have here as Michael Stephen comes into the final corner, still holding a decent lead, going round in 1 minute 9.6 tenths ahead of Mathew Hodges. Gennaro Bonafede, a second. down at him. And then, of course, Graham Nathan getting past Hennie Groenewald. Sean Dermody and Simon Moss all of a sudden seem to be finding a little bit of pace, and I'm sure he's going to make a move on Sean Dermody. Most probably going into turn two. He decided against that in turn one, but I'm sure in turn two he's definitely going to have a go as Michael Stephen controls it. Gary, the one thing that is different to what the old production cars were, these are all rear-wheel drive and two-wheel drive cars compared to what we used to have.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, so obviously a lot difficult to drive, really concentrated.
Just to let you know, Simon Moss has got past Sean Dermody, so beginning to find a little bit of a better balance in that extreme Audi. So let's see his progress.
Yeah, he obviously didn't want to interfere too much with the GTC production battle, of course, you know, with the two goals behind him, and let their guys carry on with their race. But yes, all two-wheel drives, exceptionally difficult to get the power down. And of course, no ABS. I mean, that's been the big thing. Everybody's been so used to ABS in the past with the production cars they've been racing. No ABS here, and that was probably the area which the drivers needed to concentrate on most.
Well, Michael Stevens on his next lap, all of a sudden the times 1 minute 6.6 for Mathew Hodges. And Gennaro Bonafede comes in at 1.6.9, so the time's improving drastically at 1.7.1 for Graham Nathan, and 1.79 for Hennie Groenewald. Seems to be struggling with a little bit of pace at the moment, and Simon Moss doing a great thing. Sean Dermody ahead of Daniel Rowe, Mandla Makane and Paul Hill in the production car category, and now the guys are beginning to find some serious pace. Gary, they're probably feeling the car a lot better than what it was, and racing so completely different to when you're doing practice.
Absolutely, very, very different. And of course, as we said, it's all about tire wear and the management, how you've got your car set up. But you know, you've got to say as well, Michael Stephen, very clever engineer as well as a hell of a good driver, and really so far has got all the sums right.
Having a look at Hennie Groenewald, yeah, seems to be having a couple of problems. Oh, it seemed like somebody had a bit of a spin, but just lost the pictures over there. It's also great, Gary, we've got such a great crowd here at Zwartkops. Michael Stephen goes across the start-finish grid again. 1 minute 6.5, Mathew Hodges just 2 tenths behind him. So the pace sort of seems to have settled down. But such a great crowd here, Gary. Also a tremendous amount of media, as always. But I've also bumped into some people here, Gary, who've never been to motor racing and taking photographs and doing some reporting. So we've got a great, great atmosphere at Zwartkops this afternoon.
It is. It is fantastic. I was here obviously early and saw people coming in at 6:30 this morning. So great to see. But as you said, of course, the media interest has been extremely positive coming into this event. And that is a massive plus for South African motorsport.
At the moment, it's Michael Stephen for the Engen Extreme Audi A3 team ahead of Mathew Hodges in the Volkswagen Motorsport Jetta. The gap 1.5 seconds. Gary, is there an element of complacency? You've still got another 10 laps to go. It's the longest that these guys have raced for a long time. You've got to keep your concentration throughout the whole duration of this race.
Well, exactly. It's key now. You don't want to make any mistakes. You know, being in Michael Stephen's position, it's probably easiest to do that. You've got to keep concentrating, not miss any of your braking markers, because obviously a second and a half is not a long gap. And likewise for Mathew, if they want to keep themselves in the race towards the end part of it, they need to stick as close as they possibly can, not make mistakes.
Just watching Daniel Rowe getting very close to Sean Dermody, and I know that Sean Dermody, unfortunately, from last night to this morning, lost his power steering. So I tell you, it's really going to be quite a battle for him to keep that car on the straight and narrow. He's going to try and make it as wide as possible. 1 minute 6.5 for Michael Stephen, 1.6 seconds ahead of Mathew Hodges. Then a little bit of a gap to Gennaro Bonafede in the Sasol GTC BMW. Graham Nathan seems to have left Hennie Groenewald behind. Hennie might be having some kind of problems, and I tell you, he's going to have to watch out, because Simon Moss is definitely on a charge. He's just a tenth quicker than Hennie Groenewald at the moment, but getting quicker and quicker.
Yeah, great to see Simon Moss going, because he had that big off this morning, managed to get that car fixed, hasn't done anything in comparison to what anybody else has done in terms of laps in the car.
Oh, we got a big spinner over here. It's Graham Nathan. Yeah. Unfortunately, Graham Nathan had a bit of a spin coming out of turn seven. So I tell you, guys just pushing it as well. Gary just not used to how the car's actually going to develop as the race progresses.
Yeah, and also very physical cars. You know, these cars require a lot from the driver. And again, you know, in racing, when you do start to get slightly tired, you lose concentration, you go off the road. But obviously, just trying too hard there to try and close that gap, and has lost the car. We sort of expected to see this kind of thing as the race wore on.
There we go. Graham Nathan, unfortunately, has lost his position to Hennie Groenewald, but he's definitely going to have to drive. I don't know where Simon Moss has gone. Simon Moss has gone.
off our timing sheets over here, so just trying to see what's happened to Simon. Just trying to see if there are any yellow flags at the moment. It's Michael Steven from Mathew Hodges, Gennaro Bonafede, Hennie Groenewald, Graham Nathan, and Simon Hill. Simon Moss has dropped down to 12th position. Don't know exactly what has gone on. We'll try and get you an update now.
Yeah, just looking at the lap times as well. So we're basically halfway through this race. The previous lap, Mathew Hodges did identical time to Michael Steven. And it's going to be interesting to see now if this swing continues. I just wanted to have a look as they cross the line now. Yeah, it did definitely Mathew Hodges going now quicker for the first time in this race than Michael Steven. Is he going to be able to close this gap? He's got another six laps, and if he can continue like this, he does have a chance of taking, having a shot at the lead.
Yeah, definitely. I tell you, a very, very strong drive from Mathew Hodges. And I tell you, a great drive also with Sean Dermody and Daniel Rowe in the production car category as well as they go into turn one. As we see one of the... you can see the leader, Michael Steven, just passing the back marker at the right up, going up to the tabletop.
Yeah, definitely got a little bit bulk by the, in the by that lap car. It's certainly going to help Mathew Hodges. It depends if Hodges can catch that car before the tabletop and get through the twisty bits without being held up. We want to see a race here. As I said, Mathew Hodges really coming on song now.
Well, I've got to tell you, Graham Nathan definitely got the red mist. He's really catching Hennie Groenewald. I'm very can't wait to see Graham Nathan's next time. Michael Steven crosses over lap seven, and just behind him is Mathew Hodges. The gap before was 1 minute 1.6. it's actually gone up a little bit to just over 2 seconds.
He definitely got held up by the traffic, unfortunately. He was right there and lost a couple of tens at lap. He was lapping at the same time, lost about half a second in trying to pass the lap traffic.
Just heard Hennie Groenewald coming past. It sounded like a little bit of a misfire, I got to say. Hennie Groenewald, 1:08, and Graham Nathan, 1:07. So Hennie Groenewald getting chased down by Graham Nathan. Graham will want to make up for that recovery after he spun at the tabletop. But Michael Steven seems to have everything in place over Mathew Hodges, but Mathew Hodges really pushing hard, but did lose a full half a second because of the back markers. And I think Michael Steven got past just before the tabletop, and unfortunately Mathew Hodges had to wait for those cars for the next opportunity.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's, I want to see the lap times as they cross the line. They're coming into the final corner now. Let's see what they're doing there. Mathew Hodges had done all the hard work and unfortunately was undone by the lap car, but Michael Steven has just crossed the line.
Michael Steven, 1:06.7 and 1:06.8 for Mathew Hodges. Nothing between them. And we've got Gennaro Bonafede in third position, 1:07. So the BMs is a little bit off the pace, Gary, compared to the likes of the Audi and the VW.
Yeah, they certainly are. As you quite rightly said, Hennie's car not sounding very, very good at all. So unfortunately for him, that's not going to allow him to really get into the thick of it. But yeah, not quite on the pace. Obviously, everybody's just finding their way around at this first event. But up to front, we've got the Audi A3, the Engen Audi A3 of Michael Steven and the VW Motorsport Jetta, Mathew Hodges. I must say, I haven't seen a better looking Jetta than that, but catching that Audi.
It does look very good. Just to let you know, Paul Hill's got past Daniel Rowe. He's definitely going to chase down Sean Dermody. Coming up to the tabletop, looking at one of the BMWs going into the right-hander. And it's still Michael Steven. And I tell you, Mathew Hodges does look a little bit closer as they make their way down to the final corner. Michael Steven comes into the corner. Mathew Hodges definitely looks closer on this lap. With five laps to go, will he be able to do anything? A 1:07.5 compared to a 1:07.0. So half a second pulled out from Mathew Hodges, and it's only 1.6 seconds between the two drivers. In third position, 4 seconds down the road, Gennaro Bonafede and Hennie Groenewald being chased down. Oh, you can see, there we go, Graham Nathan down the main straight. Looks like he's going to take him going into turn one. Yes, you can see Hennie Groenewald does have some problems, but I tell you, a great move again from Graham Nathan. He'll feel vindicated after his spin, but nobody knows what he could have done, unfortunately, after having that spin. And it makes you a little bit furious in your own inside your helmet.
It does indeed, because you know you want to be in it. And just looking at, again, the lap traffic really playing a part in this race now. Again, Mathew Hodges being caught mid-corner by some lap traffic, but nonetheless still definitely seems to be closing with Michael Steven. Half a second faster that time. I don't know if Michael had made a mistake or not, but there was a big difference in the lap time.
It's you never know, the tires could be acting a little bit slower. The lap traffic's definitely affected the times as well, but the gap between Michael Steven and Mathew Hodges Well, it seems to be a little bit static, but we'll tell you now, it was 1.6 seconds between the two. It is now 1.5, so just a tenth between the two. Gennaro Bonafede in third position, a 1:08, so lap traffic definitely caught him. He lost another 2 seconds down there, and Graham Nathan should come through in fourth position ahead of Graham Nathan. Simon Moss still languishing down in 12th position, so definitely some kind of a problem, but that's most probably just because of what happened in qualifying, something not right to the car. I'm sure they'll try and figure it out and fix it for the second race this afternoon. Well, the BMW has got ahead of Sean Dermody and Daniel Rowe having a go. Sean Dermody making that focus very, very wide. Gary, you'll know about that, having driven that car in the past.
Yeah, look, we had some great races there, and Sean doing a great job there. So he's leading in the GC production class now, followed by Daniel Rowe, Mandela Madakani, and Shaul Smallberger. So, yeah, looking good. And great comeback. And Sean hasn't raced for a while, so good to see him on the pace so quickly. And he hasn't raced, I think, for the past 8-9 months. So good to see him out there.
Matthew Hodges, and the gap between him and Michael Stevens seems to be static. Both of them really, really pushing into the 12th lap. 1.6 seconds. And I tell you, Gennaro Bonafede, that seemed like a very, very good lap compared to 1:07. So it's about half a second off the pace of the Audi and the VW Jetta. Just two laps to go. Graham Nathan crosses over the line now. Also got stuck in a little bit of lap traffic. He's in fourth position, and he does a time of 1:07.9. So 1.1 seconds off the leaders. But a great scrap. I mean, Michael Stevens must be looking in his mirrors, Gary, a lot. Matthew Hodges is just saying, come on, make a mistake, make a mistake. I'm ready to bite at you.
Well, I tell you what, Matthew, certainly the guy was something to prove here. First time out in a car of this sort of nature in South Africa. And, you know, being up there, as I said earlier on, just doing a fantastic job for the team. But Michael Stevens, you know, one of the most experienced guys out there for sure. I think from looking at the times here, has everything pretty much in control. I think just keeping that gap now at sort of a level that's manageable for him, and not putting himself at too much risk. Matthew, on the other hand, has to push, really put everything on the line here to try and make it.
Michael Stevens comes across the line, lap 13, one lap to go after this, and does a 1:07.5, so very, very static, 1.6 seconds between the two leaders. A consummate professional in Michael Stevens, multiple South African champion. Gary, so dedicated to motorsport and motor racing, and one of those drivers who gets stuck in, really.
Absolutely.
Stuck in when it comes to building and setting up these cars.
Absolutely. I mean, I think what people need to know is Michael is really integral in this Terry Moss Racing team. I think at that workshop, that is his job, making sure these cars are quick, and of course you can drive them quickly as well. So I think they'll be well chuffed. And of course, you were definitely a favorite, you know, in the build-up to this first race, you know, of GTC, just knowing what he can do from a technical point of view. And as I said, coupled up, get up with a hell of a good driving. Michael, a very package.
Michael Stevens coming into the tabletop. Matthew Hodges looks a little bit closer, but I think Michael Stevens definitely has this under control. As Gary mentioned, I think he's just pacing himself, making sure he gets to the end. The BMW of Gennaro Bonafede in third position, as we're watching Will Simon Moss, unfortunately, just about getting challenged. But there we go, our first winner of the Sasol GTC series. Right here, Michael Stevens from the Engen Extreme Audi A3. Second position goes to Mathew Hodges in the Volkswagen Motorsport Jetta. Third position to Gennaro Bonafede in the Sasol BMW GTC, and crossing the line right now, Graham Nathan in fourth position, Hennie Groenewald coming across in fifth position. Simon Moss unfortunately having some issues a little bit earlier, but will manage to finish through. First ever GTC race right here at Zwartkops. Our winner, Michael Stevens, from pole position. But I tell you, we were nervous in the commentary box. How were you out there?
No, it was pretty cool and collected. Been there, done it a couple of times before, so yeah, I think it all went well. And you know, I think that's the trick to being fast and consistent, is just to keep a cool head when you're out there.
I've got to tell you, watching you and Mathew Hodges right behind you, you seem to control the pace very, very well. Your times are improving, but the sort of lap traffic seemed to pose a little bit of a problem.
Yeah, I pushed a little bit in the beginning just to get away, and then I saw I had a bit of a gap, so I thought I'll just control the gap. And then we came across some back markers and got pushed back a little bit, but there was still enough margin just to take it easy to the end.
Mathew Hodges, the VW Motorsport Jetta, what a fantastic debut in GTC for you. Brilliant drive.
Yeah, I think that's what we needed. The car's amazing. The team did a brilliant job. I can't fault them. They gave me the best car. Each session I went out, we found a lot of pace from yesterday. Made up a lot on Michael, so I got to just thank the team. It's a good reward and a good show for Gugu.
Sasol GTC BMW driver Gennaro Bonafede making it onto the podium third, but not quite the pace to catch the Jetta and the Audi in front of you.
Yeah, indeed. Look, I mean, it's the first time I've done more than 4 laps in a row in the car, so it's phenomenal to drive this puppy for 14 laps in a row. Not a bad race. You know, obviously we're struggling with a little bit of a misfire. We're trying to sort it out, but you know what? A safe car is the way to go. You know, you've got to finish first. I don't know. I'll get it right eventually.
You've got to first finish. To finish first, something like that.
Yeah.
But Gennaro, as you mentioned, I mean earlier on, you guys did have some misfire problems. It seems as though it hurt your teammate.
Yes.
But the main thing is you guys got through it. You guys are going to work harder and hopefully be a little bit more competitive in the second race.
100%. You know, I can see, you know, towards the track with other front two guys in the early laps, the top section we're okay. You know, the handling, but we're okay. It's just these straights. Obviously, we lose our short shifting just to maintain the safety of the engine. But listen, the Sasol GTC team have done a fantastic job. The Beamer looks good, sounds good, and it handles well over 14 laps. So we'll work on it, just early days.
Another father of the GTC baby is well-known engineer Vic Maharaj. We caught up with him about building these magnificent machines.
The process of getting a car like this together is quite complex. It essentially starts, as you probably see behind me, we've got the frame or the chassis or the roll cage, as many people know it. We've effectively got to jig the car up, the CAD drawings and the CAD models to make sure that the chassis is correct and repeatable as per these CAD drawings. It then gets fabricated. By that I mean the tubes are bent, they cut, they notched and they welded together. Once the chassis is done, essentially we get it here, we put it onto this jig behind me, and the jig is essentially making sure that the chassis are all positioned in the correct place. We put the bodies on, the bodies go for painting, and then after painting we start to do an assembly and a trial fitment of the body panels, the wheel arches, the splitters, the bumpers, and then obviously you look at all the internal structures like wiring harnesses, instrumentation, driver seats, ergonomics, and obviously the suspension fuel tank. So literally thousands and thousands of parts, a big logistical and project management challenge. But you know, the team has risen to the challenge, and it's something that we really love doing. I think with the three manufacturers that we've got now is a very, very good start. If you look at Australian V8 supercars, essentially they started with two core manufacturers, DTM with three core manufacturers, NASCAR with two core manufacturers. So we've kind of hit that target square on the head, and we've got very, very good quality manufacturers behind us, so we're happy with that. However, obviously your ambitions have to kind of exceed what you really have right now. You always want to improve the show and make it better, and South Africans love their cars, they love their brands, they're very loyal to their brands. So yes, we are trying and we are working behind the scenes flat out to try and get more cars and more manufacturers behind us.
Well, look, I think overall, if you look at it as GTC, you got to say that it's mission accomplished. We had six starters, all six cars finished. Obviously, we had some guys spinning in corners and stuff, but hey, that's what racing's all about. Fantastic job for the Engen Audi team who've managed to win the inaugural race. Michael Stephen did a brilliant job. I got to say, Mathew Hodges, I got to take my hat off for him, but really, Gennaro Bonafede, Hennie, Groenewald, part of my team, really did a great job. We had a few technical issues that we had to try and overcome, but you know, in reality, you got to finish the races. It's a long season, and in the end, if you're finishing races, you're seeing the checkered flag, you actually score points, and you're in the championship towards the end of the year. This is what South African motorsport really needs, and overall, you got to say that the drivers provide the spectacle. They love driving the cars. The technology in the cars is fantastic, and the best thing of all, it's homegrown South African talent.
Michael Stephen won the first race in the Sasol GTC Championship. It was up to the others as to see whether they could catch him in race two. Let's go and find out. The safety car has gone into the pit lane.
Yeah, we're lining up now. We've got the cars bunching up coming around the final turn. We've got Michael Stephen on pole position. Of course, Mathew Hodges next to him in that VW Jetta. And let's see how this one is going to shape up.
Michael Stephens will determine the starting grid. They're getting up a little bit of pace here. Let's go racing. Michael Stephen gets on the throttle really, really hard. Mathew Hodges down in the inside, but Gennaro Bonafede right up close there to Mathew Hodges going in there. We've heard that, unfortunately, Hennie Groenewald is still suffering from that misfire problem, so they have actually parked the car into the garage. But it is Michael Stephen who is leading the way at the moment with Mathew Hodges behind him, Gennaro Bonafede, Graham Nathan, he's the man to watch. Simon Moss there also looking pretty aggressive as well.
Yeah, certainly. So let's hope Matthew can keep it closer to Michael in the opening laps this time. We know the last time throughout the race, mid-distance, certainly was catching Michael for a bit. And I believe this heat, if he can keep it up there, he certainly will have a chance going in towards the latter part of the race.
Michael Stevens coming up to the tabletop, Mathew Hodges right behind him. It looked as though Gennaro Bonafede was driving very defensively. Here comes Graham Nathan down the inside. Is he going to be able to do anything? No. But I tell you, I think Graham Nathan's definitely got this... got the bit between his teeth there, but Simon Moss all over him as well. So 1 minute he's got to drive aggressive, but he's also got to drive defensive.
Yeah, that's always a difficult thing, and that's what touring car racing is about. You know, it's about racing door to door and just really being up there and dealing with the pressure all around. But as you said, Simon Moss really now hanging with the Graham Nathan, as I said, got to grips with this car and looking a lot better now.
Coming down through turn one, also looking at some of the production cars there. A little bit of a snatch on the steering wheel from I think it was Daniel Rowe in the GTI, as Michael Stevens leads after the first lap. Mathew Hodges a little bit of a gap, 0.7 seconds. Graham Nathan falling behind, and Simon Moss seems to have lost a little bit of grip coming out of turn two.
Yeah, and Daniel Rowe looking in, they got a nice lead in the GTC production class. In fact, hanging on to the back of that Audi, so really going well in that Gold GTI. Oh, it looks like Moss has got some problems.
Yeah, Moss has got some problems, unfortunately, slowing down through turn four. Looks like that's going to be another retirement. Unfortunately, a very difficult weekend for him, as we're looking at Graham Nathan right over the back of Gennaro Bonafede. Oh, he goes to look on the inside there. He runs a little bit wide. Does Bonafede? Can Graham Nathan get the drag? We're looking at them. Michael Stephen. Oh, and we got Graham Nathan coming down on the outside. Is Gennaro Bonafede going to be able to hold him? He does be able to hold him, but this is a drag straight down the straight here, Gary.
Yeah, so if Graham can stick around the outside going into turn one, he's going to set himself up nicely for turn two. Oh, and he's side by side
through
turn one.
Goes around the outside there, running wide there. I tell you, great driving from both of these. It looks like Graham Nathan's going to have him on the inside going into the hairpin. Simon Moss, unfortunately, coasting round, going to be bringing his car to retirement. It is Michael Stephen then from Mathew Hodges. And yes, Graham Nathan has got the jump on Gennaro Bonafede. The four cars in the Sasol GTC at the moment. Michael Stephen leading the way, Mathew Hodges in second place, and then of course the other VW Jetta of Graham Nathan in third. Can Graham Nathan do anything about his teammate?
Yeah, unfortunately, in the GTC production car, looks like we've got Mandla Madakane also in the pits in that Golf 7 from VW Motorsport. Unfortunately, looks like he's incurred some issues.
Gennaro Bonafede not giving up, as we're watching Michael Stephen coming down there, followed by Mathew Hodges. And I think that is Simon Moss. Yeah, so he's carrying on going. Gary hasn't brought it into the pits.
Yeah, well, we're on the wrong car there. We need to be looking at Michael Stephen out in the front of the race with Mathew Hodges right behind him. Looking at the production class here, that is Charles Smallberger in front of Sean Dumini, who won the opening race today.
There we go. Gennaro Bonafede not giving up, chasing down Graham Nathan. Going to be a great scrap between these two. Puffs of smoke coming out of that car going into turn two. And it is Mathew Hodges in second place, and then behind them, Graham Nathan and Gennaro Bonafede.
Yeah, Graham seemed to really, you know, have the legs on Gennaro when he overtook him, but Gennaro now hanging in there. So let's hope we'll see a fight back from Gennaro in that BMW.
I think there he goes. We go through turn four, going up the hill to the tabletop. It is Michael Stephen with a 1.9-second lead over Mathew Hodges. And Graham Nathan, well, we're just looking at their times, a little bit slower than Mathew Hodges. Graham Nathan trying to get a little bit of a pickup there. Gennaro Bonafede, I suppose with that misfire, Gary, you never know. It could be intermittent and unfortunately becomes very frustrating.
It could be, and that could well be the reason that Graham was able to get past. He really looked quick, especially up here at the top of the tabletop, looking very, very good. But now hanging on, and you can see very, very close to Graham Nathan, so not looking too bad. The times are definitely a lot slower than they were this morning. That's obviously, you know, taking the heat into consideration. Mathew Hodges, for example, has done a 6.9. Michael Stevens done a 7. So looking pretty much as it did early on into the race, Mathew Hodges seemed to have the quicker car.
Yeah, that's for sure. That happened in heat one. 107 to a 106 at the moment. Graham Nathan in a 107.5. Great scrap. Sean Dermody trying his best in the GTC production cars. But Michael Stephen, hard on the brakes, goes into turn four with Mathew Hodges behind him. And Gary, this pull-up to the tabletop braking is essential coming up here.
Exactly. Two things. Getting out of turn four cleanly to get the good pull up the hill. And, of course, then braking, as you said, very, very tight corner to the right hand at the top of the hill here. But Michael Stephen, I must say, really driving well, looking impressive. The car looking very, very smooth.
I've got to say there, just a little bit of a wobble going through turn seven. Matthew Hodges doing his best. You can know he's driving as fast as he can to try and catch up with Michael Stephen. Michael Stephen, a composed racing driver, true professional as well, comes into the start-finish line, finishes the end of lap number five of 1 minute 7.2, 2/10 slower than Matthew Hodges. So Matthew Hodges doing his best to try and catch up with him. And Graham Nathan, Gennaro Bonafede, 4/10 between them. Looks like we've got a change in the GTC production car. Sean Dermody, and I'm just trying to see, seems to have gotten ahead of
Charles Smallberg, I think it is there.
Here we go. So now he's got to chase down Daniel Rowe.
Yeah, Daniel Rowe's really driven well this heat. Pulled at a nice gap now, comfortable. He can look after the brakes, look after the tyres in the position that he's in.
Got a move there. The Z4 going around the inside of the BMW 3 Series in the GTC production cars.
Looks like he's putting a bit of a gap on Charles Smallberger and chasing down Daniel Rowe. So he's got another 9 laps to do something about him. We'll just try and have a look at the lap times and see where we are, how the two of them are looking. Daniel Rowe looking very good, doing 9.8. Sean Dooman in his last lap did a 10.4, and that was with overtaking Charles Smallberger. So let's see what his lap time's doing clean there.
Well, just coming through our commentary position, we've seen Graham Nathan with Gennaro Bonafede. The gap between them pretty static at the moment. So Gennaro doing his best. Hopefully that car is okay. And we get back to the leaders on our screen over here. Michael Stephen in after 6 laps, making his way through turn 3. And then, of course, the mighty turn 4. Gary, quite a corner, depending on how you brake, and still a potential passing opportunity.
It is obviously very difficult. The braking is hard there. It's not as, you don't slow down to the effect that you would going into this to the right hand at the tabletop. But yeah, but more importantly, setting the car up in turn 4 to get that drive up the hill. That is essential. That's where you can make or lose a lot of time.
Matthew Hodges getting a very good turn out of the tabletop there, chasing down Michael Stephen. You get into that part where those tyres, you just don't want to overcook them, but they might also get much grippier and we could see some even better times coming through.
Well, let's see. So let's say as they cross the line now, we have Michael Stephen is seeing to update it, doing a 6.7, Matthew a 6.8. So 10 quicker that lap for Michael Stephen. Of course, he's encountered a bit of traffic as well. Looks like Matthew's got through there pretty cleanly.
Yeah, which is good. He could have been held up going into the turn two hairpin, as we see was Graham Nathan going through into turn two. But Michael Stephen got a comfortable lead, 1.6 seconds above Matthew Hodges. And Graham Nathan still ahead of Gennaro Bonafede.
Yeah, I think Michael's got it pretty well taped today. I think just pacing himself nicely. Sort of, you know, Matthew can make up a bit of ground and Michael's able to just keep it nice and constant. I think he does have something in hand, just looking how he's able to control that gap.
Yeah, it's also a guy who knows this circuit, or every circuit in South Africa, exceptionally well. So doing a superb job in that extreme Audi A3, followed by the Volkswagen Motorsport Jetta A3, and then the other Volkswagen Motorsport Jetta coming through. And then, of course, the Sasol GTC BMW of Gennaro Bonafede. Still trying his best, trying to hold on as much as possible. Every lap losing he's losing a couple of tenths to Graham Nathan, unfortunately.
Yeah, they really are now running around at the same sort of lap times. Both just done 6.9s that lap, and it's just the opening laps where Michael Stephen seems to be able to get the tyres up to temperature and open up that comfortable gap that he needs.
And that's it. As soon as he's holding that gap, then he seems to be able to maintain it no matter what he does. But it's amazing how they are pushing each other along, where their times are significantly quicker than everybody else.
Yeah, they really are in a class. Don't say there's no two ways about it. I think Graham in third place doing 7.5 on that lap there. So, you know, half a second off the front two cars this afternoon.
So currently after 8 laps, it is Michael Stephen in the Audi A3 ahead of Mathew Hodges in the VW Jetta. They're coming through the second part of the tabletop, and then of course down, you don't really see it on TV, but the sort of decline into the final corner, also hard braking area, try and run as wide as possible. There's Michael Stephen goes. Well, I tell you, the car just handles so beautifully, not even using that much of the rumble strip, but beautiful car control.
Yeah, absolutely. Sasha, you hit it there. I mean, really comfortable, not using all the road. You see Mathew using a slightly more road, and for Gennaro, for example, really pushing that BMW to the limit. You know, Michael Stephen certainly comfortable.
All of them, well, there we go. Mathew Hodges with traffic, lost quite a bit of time. There's 2.5 seconds now behind Michael Stephen as they go through turn three. And I don't see, Mathew Hodges seems to be very, very slow, Gary.
Yeah, definitely massive gap opening up there. We can't see if he's gone off or what the traffic situation was there, but definitely lost a lot of time. And Graham actually now pulling right up behind his teammate.
Yeah, I don't know if he's got a problem or if maybe he had a little bit of a spin at turn two. We didn't see anything. Watch Michael Stephen coming up to the tabletop, and that lead now quite significant over Mathew Hodges. Let's hope it's not an engine issue and another retirement, but Michael Stephens now can really look in his mirrors and be very comfortable and, well, just control his pace as he wants.
Yeah, certainly. He's got all the comfort in the world right now. He can do whatever he needs. Look after the brakes, look after the tyres. No need to push it on to the absolute limit.
Michael Stephens crosses over the start-finish line at 1:07.113. Mathew Hodges' time is going to be very interesting. You can hear it. Doesn't sound good at all for Mathew Hodges at 1:12. But the car sounded very rough coming past our commentary position. And now Graham Nathan looks like he's going to swoop on him. And more than likely, Gennaro Bonafede. Yeah, huge problems for Mathew Hodges going into turn two. And I'm sure we're going to see a change of position as they make their way up to turn three.
Yeah, what a disappointment for Mathew Hodges. Driven well all day, all week, in fact, in this car, being new to GTC. And you can see Graham has definitely got passing. But the car now seems to be taking, looks like it's going okay again. So something definitely looks intermittent and very, very frustrating for Mathew.
Well, these maladies, when it comes to the first day of racing in any form of category, they can catch you out when you least expect it, especially in brand new cars. They're getting the car a little bit sideways.
Yeah,
Michael Stephen, he's having a tremendous amount of fun. But you're right, Mathew Hodges seems to be holding on to Graham Nathan, and Gennaro Bonafede not really doing too much at the moment. Michael Stephens comes across the line again at 1:07.2. Seems to have backed off a little bit, and now we've got the two VW Jettas line astern. Car number 21.
It seems to be a problem as Mathew comes onto the start-finish straight. For the rest of the lap, the car seems to be okay. So something strange happening with that Jetta.
Yeah, well, I'm sure we'll find out post the race, but he's going to try, I suppose, and nurse that car all the way through to the end. But Michael Stephen having an unassailable lead now over Graham Nathan. 10 seconds is the gap between the two of them. Although I must say, Graham Nathan not that far off in terms of lap times, but Michael Stephen, I'm sure, taking it a little bit easier. Focusing on Mathew Hodges seems to be a problem, but yeah, as you're right, Gary, since that start-finish straight, something horribly goes wrong.
Yeah, absolutely. As he comes round the left-hander here, it seems to be the issue.
Michael Stephen having a lot of fun going into the second last corner of the lap here at Zwartkops. Graham Nathan now in second place, and in third place, Gennaro Bonafede.
Massive flames coming out of that Sasol BMW.
Yeah, unfortunately, Mathew Hodges is going to retire the car, drives into the pit lane. What a shame, what a disappointment after a brilliant first round and first race.
Well, I've just seen a whole lot of smoke coming out of Graham's exhaust going into turn one, so I'm hoping that the same problem doesn't affect him, but I definitely noticed some smoke coming out of that car.
Well, it is a hot winter's day here in the city of, well, just outside the city of Pretoria, and maybe these cars beginning to feel the heat underneath them as well. But Michael Stephens in great control, 11 seconds ahead. I'm just looking over here, Gennaro Bonafede not far behind Graham Nathan, but well, with only two laps to go, will he be able to do anything, and will Graham Nathan be able to hold on?
He would have noticed that smoke, if indeed it was there, if I'm not mistaken. And he'll realize that he's got to keep pushing. So should something happen in the last lap, he's going to be able to pick up that position.
Yeah, it's one of those things in racing. You just can never, ever give up. You just don't know what's going to happen. As we saw a glimpse there of Graham Nathan, Michael Stephen going into turn one. and looking very, very solid, just driving within the limits of the road. I mean, he's got this totally under control. It doesn't seem like he's going to have any issues in winning this race as well. Gennaro Bonafede, you can see here, just pushing as hard as he can to get onto the back of Graham Nathan. If anything happens, big flames coming out of that BMW into turn two with only a lap and a half to go. It's Michael Stevens looking for a double, and what a way to start the Sasol GTC series, Gary.
Well, absolute dominance today from Michael. As I said, we had a suspicion that he was the favorite for today, and it certainly proved that to be the case. He hasn't really had a problem from anybody all day, including in qualifying. Definitely the form driver.
Yeah, Michael Stephen coming across we were watching down the main straight, blue flags. Michael Stephen got one more lap to complete after this one. And Graham Nathan seems to be holding on to second position with Gennaro Bonafede in third place.
Oh, Bonafede's thrown it off.
Oh, Gennaro Bonafede has thrown it off.
On the last lap.
Oh, wow, there we go. He was pushing so hard, I think, to get to the back. But Gennaro Bonafede has thrown it off. Michael Stephen is our winner. Gennaro gets it back up, but looks as though, well, Graham Nathan will finish second, way ahead of him, but unfortunately, Gennaro just not having a good run. But Gennaro,
yeah, that was Graham Nathan score, hobbling across the line. Here comes Gennaro. I think still picks up that third position in the Sasol car, unfortunately just losing in the last lap. Obviously trying very hard to try and catch Graham in that final lap. As we said, he wasn't going to give up, and he certainly didn't.
That's for sure. There we go. It is the Sasol Global Touring Cars round two here at Zwartkops. Our winner, Michael Stephen, from Graham Nathan, Gennaro Bonafede, and then in the GTC production cars, it's Daniel Rowe, Sean Dermody, and Charles Smallberger. Round two of the Sasol GTC series right here at Zwartkops. Gennaro Bonafede, what a tussle with Graham Nathan, but shoo, you nearly lost third place.
Yeah, we had a good go, myself and Graham, for the first half of the race, and you know, the gap was there or thereabouts. We were pushing, you know, ended up going into turn six, just dropped a wheel on the outside under braking and spun the car without even, it was so quick. Really, a ballerina would have been proud. You know, we've got some positives coming out of this for sure. I think our handling is getting to be more dialed in, and I think definitely the next race we're going to give the guys a full go and challenge Michael for the win. I think he had a very good day today, but we're coming for sure.
Graham Nathan, second overall, a fantastic debut after your first race with a little bit of a spin. I tell you, you came back firing in the second.
Yeah, thank you very much. The car went very, very well. The guys worked very hard, and testimony to the dedication to motorsport. The GTC team has done a superb job of creating a new avenue, a new place for motorsport to blossom. The guys are in it, the manufacturers are excited, the crowd's excited. It's just a pumped environment at the moment. And in the first race I got a spin going. I happened to spin it right in front of the VW Boma. So the boss, old Matt, came to me and said to me, okay, thank you very much, but that's enough now. So the second one, I had to pull my finger out and try as hard as I could to get ahead of Gennaro. We didn't bend the motor cars. We had a great scrap. It's great for the crowd. It's great for racing. And at the end of the day, to start the season off like this, what more could we ask?
I tell you, when you talk about the trifecta, you can't get better than Michael Stephen. Pole position, fastest lap, and a double win. Michael, what a start to the GTC series for you.
Yeah, absolutely fantastic. Couldn't have asked for anything more. You know, just a big thanks to the team, the Engen Extreme team. They put in such a big effort, not only at the race weekend, but, you know, the weeks leading up to the race, late nights, working Saturday, Sunday. So, you know, hats off to them. They really deserve the credit. They provided me with a car that was, you know, really race-winning material and reliable. I think that's also, you know, extremely important, and, you know, the results show for themselves. I think one of the telling factors today was getting the car going quickly on cold tyres. It helped us to pull a lead quite early on. I think later on in the race the pace was very similar, but I can't complain.
The inaugural round of the Sasol GTC Championship has taken place at Zwartkops, and standing next to me, two of the co-founders and men who have hardly slept to get this underway, Vic Maharaj and Gary Famato. Vic, going to start off with you. I know you've had many, many sleepless nights, but what a fantastic debut for Sasol GTC Racing.
Yes, Sasha, thank you very much. Yeah, I would say, you know, it was a fantastic day. I think for me personally, all six cars finished the first race. I had sleepless nights worrying about it. So I think we were talking about it all the time. But overall, you got to say that it was a great debut for the Sasol GTC Championship. The cars were fantastic. The noise was great. We were always worried about the 2-litre turbocharge, you know, a la Formula One. But I must say, they didn't sound half bad. And the gearbox, I think, is what makes this car. It's the V8 supercar gearbox, the Albans transmission. It's got that brilliant whine inside the car. We were just ecstatic. And I think the fans were as well.
Gary, something like this started off as an idea a couple of years ago. I remember you and Vic just chatting about it, and for it to come to fruition to what it is today feels a little bit surreal, but you must be so proud.
Yeah, we are indeed. I mean, when those cars lined up on the grid for the first race today, I'm not going to lie to you, there were definitely a couple of goosebumps on the body and perhaps even a lump in the throat, because I know, as Vic says, what we've all been through to get the cars here today. And it's not only getting the cars on the grid, but there's been a lot of other work that's gone into it as well. So we're very proud to have it. We realized a couple of years back we needed to do something, and I think what today we established a solid base to work from. It was good, but I think we have a very strong and a solid vision as to where we want to go, and I'm happy to start working from here.
Gary, the other thing is, what a crowd that came out to Zwartkops today, and what a crowd that embraced the series, whether it was on the track, off the track as well. Yeah. Everyone going out to see the drivers, to see the cars. You guys have built something very special and something so needed in South Africa.
Well, exactly. I mean, you saw some very proud racing drivers walking around you today. I mean, just you could see, as you said, the crowd interaction within. There was a crowd outside all of the GTC pits, which, I mean, is fantastic. And, you know, to be honest with you, probably one of the best crowds I've ever seen, if not the best. So we were happy with the turnout.
Vic, when it comes to actually the engineering of the car, the styling of the cars, no expense has been spared in terms of attention to detail. These are by far the finest looking circuit racing cars that I've ever seen in South Africa.
I think it's important to realize we had production car racing a few years back. Those are not real racing cars. And I think what you've got to really look at is the excitement of the drivers when they finish driving. They come out of the race cars, they're sweating, they really worked hard. And I think we want to see these guys. They're true athletes. We want to build up these guys in the eyes of all the fans out there. These are the heroes. And we want to rebuild heroes in South Africa. We want to rebuild the industry. And I think we have a slight lift off today.
Well, I tell you, it's all happening. It's the Sasol GTC Championship. We'll be in Port Elizabeth next. Let's go racing.